this is Christopher with AGP Productions. Welcome to another edition of AGP Unboxed. Today we're going to do something a little bit different, and I hope that you miniature fans will still stick around, because I hope this is going to be an entertaining video anyway. But what we're going to do today is that we're actually going to unbox a booster box of Magic the Gathering Kaladesh, the brand new set from Wizards of the Coast for Magic the Gathering. Now, I've seen a couple of other YouTubers do this over the last few years, where they'll just take a booster box and unbox each booster pack within that box, and it's always been entertaining to watch. You know, even if the commentary is not fantastic, it's always sort of interesting, because there's always a little bit of suspense. You know, what's coming next? What are they going to get? That kind of thing. And so even, it's almost like watching, I don't know if any of you guys out there are fans of Ninja Warrior, the Japanese version, not the American version, although the American version's fine, it's just not as fun, I don't think. Anyway, you know, there's this, always this, this sort of, like, hope, even within inside yourself, even though you're not competing, you're not opening the booster boxes, you're always going, oh, I hope something cool, cool, and there's this, like, really neat suspensefulness. And I always thought that was kind of neat. So I thought, you know what? I have not done anything in Magic since Cons of Tarkir came out. I missed Fate Reforged, Dragons of Tarkir, the whole second Zendikar block, the whole Shadows block. I missed all of that stuff. I got out of Magic, basically, again. And prior to Cons, I missed out on basically everything after Theros. And prior to that, it's been a long time since I was into Magic. It was, I think, Weatherlight was the last set that I picked up in any major fashion, and that would have been, what, 96, 97, 98, somewhere in there? So it's been a very, very long time. But now that I have the financial means to get back into the hobby and to use it for what I'd like to use it for, which is a collection purpose, not necessarily a gaming purpose, to where I just go through and I attempt to collect all of the cards within a set, or you know, to be perfectly honest with you, what I'd really like to do is collect every card ever produced, but that's going to take a lot longer than, you know, a simple booster box opening. I love the artwork that's on a lot of the Magic cards. It's many of them as inspiration for miniature painting, actually, just looking at the color combinations, looking at, you know, here's a card that I don't like the artwork of, here's a card that I do like the artwork of, what's the difference in the two? You know, oh, it's this type of brush stroke, or this, you know, color combination, or this contrast of lights and darks versus, you know, all of it being of the same tone, that kind of thing. And it really helps me as a painter actually improve my paintings as well. And so, just very briefly, what I'd like to do today, and I say briefly, this is probably going to take 30 minutes or longer to go through every pack in here. There's 36 packs. We're going to go through this entire box, and we're just going to open everything on camera. Hopefully we'll get something cool. I have no idea, I think it's going to be fun. And if you guys like this, I'm probably going to purchase at least 1 to 2 booster boxes every month. Now, like I said, now that I've got the financial means to do so. So this might be a regular program. Who knows? If you like the concept, go ahead and click that like button down there. If you want to see more, feel free to leave a comment and click the like button down there. If you think this is stupid, feel free to click that like button down there and leave a comment saying it's awesome. But for right now, what we're going to do is we're going to jump back to the table, and I'm going to reset the camera up, and we're going to go through this entire booster box and see if we can find anything awesome. So, without further ado, let's go to the table and open up a booster box of Magic the Gathering Kaladesh. So, welcome to the table, everyone, and the very first unboxing of a Kaladesh booster box. This is actually the first set of Magic cards that I've even touched since Cons of Tarkir. I got out of the game for about a year and a half, and I figured, you know what, this looks like a nice set to get back in on. I actually kind of missed out on Shadows over Innistrad. I thought that would have been kind of a cool set to return in, but I don't know, I never really did pick it back up. But I figured I'd pick up a Kaladesh, and maybe that would inspire me to return to the game itself. And so, let us jump in to this very, very first box of Kaladesh and see exactly what is in store for us. Alright, so I'm going to just go ahead and pull this first entire row out and kind of set the box off to the side. And we'll do this in little bits as we go. So, hopefully this will be semi-exciting for you, and not unbelievably terrible. Assuming I can remember how to open a pack of cards. Good job, Christopher. Alright, so they have a little tear on them, and that's how we have to do it. Now, I tend to be a little more careful with my stuff, because I like to put them back in the pack after I open them, and that way it just keeps them nice and fresh and protected, and I don't have to worry about them getting scratched or anything like that. And then, when the time comes for me to actually put them into a binder, which I will at some point, they'll be ready to go. So, let's just kind of skip over the commons. I'll just breeze through them very, very quickly. And we'll get into the uncommons and the rares. I love the artwork in this set. It's very, very colorful. Very, very nice. Alright, so there we have a Wisp Weaver Angel. Pretty neat looking card. An Aetherborn Marauder. A Snare Thopter. And our rare in this pack is going to be Captured by the Consulate. It's an enchantment for 1 white and 3. Enchant creature you don't control. Enchanted creature can't attack. Whenever an opponent casts a spell, if it has a single target, change the target to enchanted creature if able. Interesting card. All right, and then a foil decoction module. Okay. Interesting. Alright, so a little foil uncommon. Kind of a nice looking card there. A lot of foil on that card, too. And then a servo token. Alright, so let me put those back in their pack and move to the next. Alright, and we'll blitz through the commons again. That's a nice looking card. I really like the artwork on that. Check that out. The Ninth Bridge Patrol. Very good color combinations. Very bright, very vivid. That one's really nice too. Prophetic Prism. I bet you that would look really nice as a foil card. Alright, let's make our way. So, Underhanded Designs is our first uncommon. Followed by Sky Whaler's Shot. I love the artwork on that. Just the idea that there are these giant whales roaming through the skies. I think it's pretty cool in and of itself. And Veteran Motorist. And then our rare is the Territorial Gorger. All right, 1 red and 3 colorless trample. Whenever you get one or more energy counters, Territorial Gorger gets +2/+2 until end of turn. An island and a construct token. All right. Set those to the side. Move on to pack number 3. I have no idea what most of these cards are worth, by the way, or whether or not they're valuable in the game. If this is your very first video for this channel, I am an artist by trade, and so I really just like the artwork, to be honest with you. That's more my my thing. So I love the artwork, and I do have a minor collection mentality, so anytime I can find like a set of something that I can complete, I tend to like doing that, so Magic is a good way to do that. Skywhaler Shot, Glimmer of Genius, Servo Exhibition, and our rare is Padim, the Consul of Innovation. Okay, then we have a mountain and a servo. I like that mountain. That's very nice. It's reminiscent, reminds me of Homelands in a way. Yes, that's right. I played Magic back when Homelands was around. Back when all the sets sucked. Well, not all of them sucked. Homelands sucked. But Fallen Empires was one of the greatest Magic sets of all time. And anyone that argues against me is wrong. Next pack. I like when they open like this. It's so much nicer. Alright. Just breezing through those commons. Ooh, I really like the detail work on that. Look at the horn there. Just the scroll work or the detail work in the horn. Very, very, very well done. Who's the artist on that? A guy named Matt Stewart. Very cool. All right. Hope I'm not going too fast. If I am, feel free to pause the video. Emerald Bruiser. Sequestered Stash. Aether Meltdown, and our rare is going to be the Skyship Stalker
to red to colorless. Minor technical difficulty there. Skyship Stalker, 2 red, 2 colorless, Flying Dragon. Skyship Stalker gets +1/+0 until end of turn, gains first strike until end of turn, gains haste until end of turn, all for 1 red mana. And we have a foil. It looks like a foil common, Sage of Shyla's Claim. Okay, 3 energy counters for a 2/1 creature. Interesting. All right. Next pack. So far, we haven't seen anything unbelievably awesome, but that's okay. We still have, let's see here, about 30-some-odd packs to go. So that's a really, really nicely done piece of art right there. Just the way the blues and the oranges play together. Very good use of complementary colors. All right. Okay, another Emerald Bruiser. Unlicensed Disintegration. Quicksmith Genius, and our rare is Midnight Oil. 2 black, 2 colorless. Enchantment Midnight Oil enters the battlefield with 7 hour counters on it at the beginning of a draw step. Draw an additional card and remove 2 hour counters from Midnight Oil. Your maximum hand size is equal to the number of hour counters on Midnight Oil. Whenever you discard a card, you lose 1 life. It's not too bad. All right, a Swamp and a Thopter. I'm not really sure why, and it could be just because I'm not used to playing the game that frequently anymore, why there are cards that allow you to increase your maximum hand size. I remember back when I used to play, I believe it was Library of Ling, way back in like the revised 4th edition type stuff. I used to love that card, and then I found, you know, having a gigantic hand is almost never a thing. You're more likely to run out of cards than you are to end up with a hand that you can't do anything with. And so, I don't know, I think it's odd. I'm not really sure how I like the artwork for these gremlins, by the way. All of these gremlin creatures seem to have this kind of weird aardvark sort of look here. I mean, look at this ruinous gremlin. Just a weird, weird appearance. I don't think this snout and this face when I think gremlins. So I don't know, I find it very strange. Arborback Stomper is first uncommon. Harsh Scrutiny. Inventor's Apprentice, and our rare is a Lathnu Hellion. 1 red, 2 colorless. Haste. When Lathnu Hellion enters the battlefield, you get 2 energy counters. At the beginning of your end step, sacrifice Lathnu Hellion unless you pay 2 energy counters. Then we have a rare foil, the Dynavolt Tower. 3 colorless. Whenever you cast an instant or sorcery spell, you get 2 energy counters. Pay 5 energy counters, and Dynavolt Tower deals 3 damage to target creature or player. That second ability is a bunch of crap. Alright, there's a Servo token, by the way. So, let's keep going. Packs open good, sometimes they don't. Alright. Ooh, I like that. That's a really, really nice piece of art right there. I like that one a lot. Appetite for the Unnatural. Okay, and just making our way through until we get to the uncommons. Harsh Scrutiny again, Trusty Companion, Experimental Aviator, and our rare is Inspiring Vantage. A land enters the battlefield tapped unless you control 2 or fewer other lands. Add white or red to your mana pool. And a Dovin emblem, which I don't think we've seen Dovin yet, but that's okay. Is it Dovin Ban, I think? I can't remember. That guy right there. Alright. So we're going to open this one here and see what we get. I'm just going to blitz through the commons once again. That's a new common we've not seen. The Woodweaver's Puzzle Knot. Very neat. Alright. Wispweaver Angel, once again. Disappearing Act. Creeping Mold, and our rare is the Bristling Hydra. 2 green, 2 colorless. When Bristling Hydra enters the battlefield, you get 3 energy counters. Pay 3 energy counters and put a +1/+1 counter on Bristling Hydra, and it gains hexproof until end of turn. That's reasonably decent, but not very great. A Servo token as well. Okay. What's this? I've not seen this yet. Story spotlights. That's interesting. I guess if you have these particular cards in some way, it can teach you the story of Kaladesh. I didn't know that Magic the Gathering sets had stories. They didn't have stories, as far as I know of, when I first started playing back in the early 90s. But apparently that's a thing now. So, good for the people at Wizards of the Folks hiring that creative team. Alright. That's pretty cool. Wayward Giant. Alright. Making our way through the commons once again. Alright, Filigree Familiar. Very, very impressed with the artwork on that card. I love the way that thing looks. Hazardous Conditions. Elegant Edgecrafters, and our rare is Wildest Dreams. One green and double X, return X cards from your graveyard to your hand, exile Wildest Dreams. Okay, and a Thopter token once again. That goes back in the pack, like so. Three more from this row, and we'll move on to row two. And hope that row two looks better than row one. Assuming we can get into the last three packs of row one. Alright. Okay. Just blitzing through these. Feel free to hit that pause button anytime you want to. I do like that card. I saw that in the previews or the spoilers for the set. I love the way the card looks. Very, very nicely done. Hazardous Conditions, once again, Speedway Fanatic, Fairgrounds, Trumpeter, and our rare is the Multiform Wonder, 5 colorless mana. You get 3 energy counters when it comes into play. You pay 1, and it gains your choice of Flying Vigilance or Lifelink until end of turn, and pay 1, and it gets either +2, -2, or -2, +2 until end of turn. Alright, and a Servo Token. Nothing yet to write home about, but that's perfectly fine. Oops. Broke the front of the package on that one. That's okay. Herald of the Fair. That's pretty nicely done. I love the color interaction there, the purple and the gold. Very great, great color combination for those of you looking to paint your miniatures in a particular color. Ballista Charger, Servant of the Conduit, Morbid Curiosity, and our rare is the Inventor's Fair, which I think was one of those cards on that storyline thing. So let's see what this says. A legendary land. At the beginning of your upkeep, if you control 3 or more artifacts, you gain 1 life. Add whatever that is to your mana pool. I think that's the new symbol for colorless mana, which is idiotic and freaking stupid. But whatever. And 4 colorless mana, sacrifice Inventor's Fair and search your library for an artifact card, reveal it, put it into your hand, and shuffle your library. And only do that if you control 3 or more artifacts. And we have a foil giant spectacle. All right. And there's an island and a beast token. That's kind of interesting. We haven't seen that yet. Okay. Keeping in mind that there's nearly 300 cards in this set, I suppose that there's going to be a lot of stuff we haven't seen yet. Even if it is tokens or commons or uncommons. And hopefully there will be some really, really nice rares as well. We haven't seen a mythic rare show up yet, as far as I remember. But that's okay. There should be about 6 per box, 5 or 6 per box, if memory serves me correctly. So hopefully we'll get in and have several of those in the next couple of rows. Ballista Charger, once again. Imperial Voyager, spelled incorrectly. Well, I guess Empyrean, that's kind of correct. Girapur Guide, and our rare is the Syndicate Trafficker. 1 black, 1 colorless, sacrifice an artifact. Put a +1/+1 counter on Syndicate Trafficker. It gains indestructible until end of turn. Well, we have a mountain, and yet another Servo token. Alright, folks, that is row number one, so let's delve now into row number two. And when I say delve, I don't mean the mechanic of delving. I mean just jumping right into these packs here. Let's see what we've got. Okay. If we can get the pack open, of course, That would help things a lot. Otherwise, this video is not going anywhere. All right, Thriving Grubs, Inspired Charge, blah, blah, blah. That would be really neat foiled, I bet. All right. Ooh, it's a lion with tusks, or a tiger with tusks. All right, Shrewd Negotiation, Oval Chase Dragster, Consul's Shield Guard, and our rare is Dubious Challenge. There's an island and a thopter. Okay. Set that there. Come on, there it is. That sort of worked. Kind of, but not really. Alright. Blitzing through the commons once again. Oh, whoop. Got into the uncommons. Oval Chase Daredevil, Inventor's Apprentice, Minister of Inquiries, and Combustible Gearhawk. Okay, so this is a 2 red, 4 colorless. First strike. When Combustible Gearhawk enters the battlefield, target opponent may have you draw 3 cards. If the player doesn't put the top 3 cards of your library into your graveyard, then Combustible Gearhawk deals damage to that player equal to the total converted mana cost of those cards. That's pretty darn interesting. I kind of like that. Ooh, and we have a foil card. Ooh, we have ourselves a Kaladesh Invention, my friends. Check this out. This is the Crucible of Worlds. You may play land cards from your graveyard. That's very interesting. I have no idea how much this card is worth, but I am very, very thankful for being able to pull a Kaladesh Invention out of this box. That is freaking awesome. So I will check out the cost on that sometime soon. Boy, that is really interesting. Look at the, let's see if we can take the Mythic Rare here, and I'll show you the difference in this. Look at just the difference in the border. I don't know if you can tell or not, but the border, the black even on this one, is actually foiled. It's like a shiny border versus this one, which is a nice matte border. That is really, really cool. Okay, so I'm going to definitely be extra careful with this set. Let's see. What is it called again? Crucible of Worlds. Very neat. Very, very cool. All right, so we're going to put that pack away. Well, that was an awesome pull. I like that. Got a Mythic and an Invention all in the same box, or all in the same pack. That was a good pack, my friends. All right. So, let's see what else we can get in this set, or in this box here. Okay, Nature's Way. Beautiful artwork on that. That is cool looking. All right, Durable Handicraft, Perpetual Timepiece, and our rare is Aetherflux Reservoir, 4 colorless. Whenever you cast a spell, you gain 1 life for each spell you've cast this turn. Pay 50 life, Aetherflux Reservoir deals 50 damage to target creature or player. Very, very crap second ability. I've never in my life been in a game where someone had more than 50 life. I guess if you're playing Commander, you might end up there, but in a normal game, I do mostly limited stuff when I play, and it just doesn't end up that way. Alright, again, working through the commons. Nature's Way, yet again. Underhanded Designs, underhanded. Creeping Mold, and our rare is the Spine Bluff Canal. Enters the battlefield tapped unless you control 2 or fewer lands. Add blue or red to your mana pool. Island, and a Nissa Emblem. Pretty neat. Okay. Still liking that Invention. That was pretty darn neat. I'm thankful that that was in this box. I was hoping for an Invention. Didn't know which one I might get, or if I would get one. I'm not sure if they've got the same rarity that the Zendikar Expeditions had back when that set was out, where it was, I think, 1 per case. But I do know that they are more rare than normal, even the Mythic Rares. Fabrication Module, Harness Lightning, Visionary Augmenter, and our rare is Master Trinketeer. 1 white, 2 colorless servos and thopters you control get +1/+1. Create a 1/1 servo colorless servo artifact creature token for 1 white and 3 mountain and a servo. But yeah, I know that the the Zendikar Expedition cards, the lands, were quite rare. And I think that these Kaladesh Inventions have the same rarity, where it's one per case. I could be incorrect in that that thought process, though. And I apologize if I am. I'm just not as up to speed with Magic as I used to be. Alright. There's a common we've not yet seen. Built to Last. Okay. I don't recall seeing it. Let's put it that way. Okay. Harnessed Lightning, Elegant Edgecrafters, Whirler Maker, and our rare is Garapur Orrery. Each player may play an additional land on each of his or her turns. At the beginning of each player's upkeep, if that player has no cards in hand, that player draws three cards. That's actually a really, really decent rare. I like that one. Plains and a Servo. Okay. So let's put that away. Let's open this puppy up. Okay, we'll do this one from the top if we can. Come on. Any day now. There we go. Look at that. Perfect. Alright. Okay. Decocotion module. That is such a stupid name. I can't get over how dumb that is. Servo Exhibition, Diabolic Tutor, and finally Gonti, Lord of Luxury, as our rare. Two black, two colorless with Death Touch. When Gonti, Lord of Luxury, enters the battlefield, look at the top four cards of the target opponent's library, exile one of them face down, put the rest on the bottom of the library in any random order. For as long as that card remains exiled, you may look at it, you may cast it, and you may spend mana as though it were mana of any type to cast it. That's not bad for a four mana cost creature. Attune with Aether is our foil. We have a really nice looking swamp and a transformerish looking construct creature that is very obviously taken right out of the first Transformers film, and I'd be surprised if Wizards doesn't get sued by Hasbro for that one. Alright, next. What do we have? We have Acrobatic Maneuver. Inventor's Goggles, we haven't seen that one yet. I like that card. Oh, well, I like the way it looks anyway. Let's put it that way. Okay. Decocotion module, yet again. They just want me to say that freaking word more frequently than anything else. Arborback Stomper, Morbid Curiosity, and Eliminate the Competition. That is an absolutely brutal-looking card. I saw that in the previews. The dude grabbed the other guy's hand and then stabbed through his own hand into the wrist of the other guy. That is just frightening. Anyway, it's one black, four colorless. As an additional cost to cast Eliminate the Competition, sacrifice X creatures, and you get to destroy X target creatures. Pretty decent card, I guess. A little heavy in the cost, but not too bad. Real quick. There we go. Oval Chase Dragster, Gear Shift Ace, Spark of Creativity, and our rare is Concealed Courtyard. Same thing as the other lands, but this one is white and black. We have a mountain and a servo. So far, one mythic. That's very interesting. I think it's been one mythic, if I recall correctly. Go back and take a look again, but I believe it's just one mythic. Alright. Let's do this again. Go back to the uncommons. Aether Torch Renegade. Again, loving that blue and red combination. That is really, really just gorgeous to look at. Experimental Aviator. Brazen Scourge with some ugly gremlins on it. And our rare is another mythic. This is the Sky Sovereign Console Flagship 5, colorless mana. Whenever Sky Sovereign Console Flagship enters the battlefield or attacks, it deals 3 damage to target creature or planeswalker an opponent controls. And it requires a crew of 3 in order to actually use it as a creature. That's a decent card. 5 mana for a 6.5 flyer. That's not too bad, my friends. And it only takes somebody else with a power of 3, or a combination of somebody else's with a power of 3. That's not bad. Let's see what else we can find. Alright. Going through. Ooh, there's a common we haven't seen. The Metal Spinner's Puzzle Knot. And let's get to the uncommons. Another Aether Torch Renegade, Filigree Familiar, Consulate Surveillance, and our rare is Lost Legacy. 2 black and 1 colorless. Name a non-artifact, non-land card. Search target player's graveyard, hand, and library for any number of cards with that name and exile them. That player shuffles his or her library, then draws a card for each card exiled from hand. This way. Alright, a swamp and a thopter. Okay. And last pack in row 2. Getting to the uncommons. That's very nice looking. A Weaponcraft Enthusiast, Long-finned Sky Whale, Janjeet Sentry, and our rare is Insidious Will. 2 blue, 2 colorless, choose one. Counter target spell, or you may choose new targets for target spell, or copy target instant or sorcery spell. You may choose new targets for the copy. Alright. Not too bad. Combination of several other cards that I've played with in the past, counterspell, deflects, things like that. Alright, and finally, row number 3. So let's see what row number 3 has in store for us. I certainly hope there are at least 2 mythic rares in this row. Oh, shucks, I guess I'll have to open this in. Maybe? Yeah. Okay. Seeing some commons I haven't seen yet previously. Okay. Uncommons. We have Cloud Blazer, Janjeet Sentry, Servant of the Conduit, and our rare is the Marionette Master. 2 black, 4 colorless. Fabricate 3. And when an artifact you control is put into a graveyard from the battlefield, target opponent loses life equal to Marionette Master's power. That's reasonable, I guess. Not one that I would immediately say, wow, let me have it. But, it's okay. If I had the choice between that and a lightning bolt, I'd take the lightning bolt. Alright. Thriving Grubs. Alright. That reminds me of the old, what was it called? It was an assassin miniature, royal assassin. Sort of this guy hiding behind the side of a wall. Kind of a neat look. Alright. Bomat Bazaar Barge. Glint Nest Crane. Gearshift Ace. And our rare is Animation Module. Whenever one or more +1/+1 counters are placed on a permanent you control, you may pay 1. If you do, create a 1/1 colorless or rote artifact creature token. 3 and tap gives you choose a counter. On target, choose a counter on target, permanent, or player. Give that permanent or player another counter of that kind. Alright. We have a foil Mind Rot, a mountain, and servo token. Alright. I've always wanted, seeing that thing about counters on players, I've always wanted to see a successful poison counter deck. Never seen one, ever. But I would like to see one happen. There it is. Alright. Cutting through the commons to get to the uncommons. Like that Bomat Bazaar Barge right there. The Engineered Mite. The Diabolic Tutor. And a rare of Dipala, the Pilot Exemplar. 1 white, 1 red, 1 colorless. All other dwarves you control get +1/+1. Each vehicle you control gets +1/+1 as long as it's a creature. And whenever Dipala Pilot Exemplar becomes tapped, you may pay X. If you do, reveal the top X cards of your library and put all dwarf and vehicle cards from among them into your hand and the rest on the bottom of your library in a random order. We also have a foil long-finned sky whale. All right. Put that back in there. And let's see what else we have in store for us today. Okay. Unlicensed Disintegration, Demolition Stomper, Incendiary Sabotage, and our rare is Paradoxical Outcome. One blue, three colorless, return any number of target non-land, non-token permanents you control to their owner's hands. Draw a card for each card returned to your hand this way. That's interesting that it's draw a card for each card returned to your hand this way, not for cards returned to anyone's hand. So if you happen to be controlling some of your opponent's stuff, you don't get to draw a card for those. That sort of sucks. Alright, so... well, forget that. I can't get it back in the package perfectly, but that's fine. No worries. Alrighty. Hello. Let's go back here to the uncommons. Demolition Stomper. Consoles Shield Guard. Disappearing Act. Ooh, and we have a mythic rare, a Noxious Gearhulk. Two black, four colorless with menace. Noxious Gearhulk enters the battlefield. You may destroy another target creature. If a creature is destroyed this way, you gain life equal to its toughness. That's okay, I guess. I like the red guy better, though. The red guy seems really, really powerful. The black one, not quite as much. Alright, so let's go into this next pack. Come on. There we go. And let's see what we have here. Fairgrounds Warden, Minister of Inquiries, Armorcraft Judge, and our rare is Electrostatic Pummeler. Three mana, three colorless. When Electrostatic Pummeler enters battlefield, you get three energy counters. Pay three, Electrostatic Pummeler gets +X/+X until end of turn, where X is its power. That's actually pretty darn cool. I gotta be honest with you. If you have something else that can create energy counters, you can basically berserk your guy multiple times, which is really nice. I sort of like that card. Even though it's just a 1/1 for three mana, I can see it getting very big very quick and being a major, major game changer. Okay. And what, six packs left? All right. See what's in store for us. And we're going to go back to the uncommons. Fairgrounds Warden, Fabrication Module, Brazen Scourge, and our rare is Kambal, the Console of Allocation. One black, one white, one colorless, and whenever an opponent casts a non-creature spell, that player loses two life, and you gain two life. A mountain and a servo token. Okay. Let's see. Getting back to the uncommons. There we go. Aetherborn Marauder, Cloud Blazer, Glimmer of Genius, and our rare is a mythic, and it is Nissa, the Vital Force Planeswalker. Two green, three colorless. Gosh, that's a lot of text to read, so here, Merry Christmas. Read that. There you go. Just pause it right there. There you go. Okay, you can read that. There you go. Planes and a servo token. That's cool. Glad I picked out one of the planeswalkers. That's very, very nice. I was kind of hoping it would be Chandra. But I'll take Nissa. That's pretty darn cool in and of itself. Okay, and we're going to go back to the uncommons. Fretwork Colony, Whirler Maker, Quicksmith Genius, and our rare is the Cultivator of Blades. That is two green and three colorless. Fabricate two. Cultivator of Blades attacks, you may have other attacking creatures get +X/+X until end of turn, where X is Cultivator of Blades' power. I find that very interesting that it says you may have other attacking creatures get +X/+X. Why would you not have other attacking creatures get +X/+X? I don't know. That's very strange. Ooh, a foil mountain. Well, that will go right into a deck somewhere because you can never have too much foil land. Actually, you can never have too much snow-covered land. Alright. One more time. Open the pack. Pull out the cards. Go to the uncommons. And we find ourselves with a Fretwork Colony. A Shrewd Negotiation. An Era of Invention. And our rare is Saheeli's Artistry. Two blue, four colorless. Choose one or both. Create a token that's a copy of target artifact. Create a token that's a copy of target artifact. Copy of target creature, except that it's an artifact in addition to its other types. That's pretty cool. An island and a construct. I don't believe we've seen that construct yet. Very nice looking card. Alright, two more packs to go. And we can call this a video. We can call it a video right now if you really want to. I mean, it is technically a video that we're watching, or that you guys are watching, and I'm filming. So, it's already a video. Let's see what the last couple of packs hold for us. Imperial Voyager, Oval Chase Daredevil, Trusty Companion, and our rare is Key to the City. Two colorless, tap to discard a card, or tap, discard a card, enough to one target creature can't be blocked this turn. Whenever Key to the City becomes untapped, you may pay two. If you do so, draw a card. That's not horrible. I think that's reasonable. I mean, that's basically, if you use it just for its card drawing ability, you get to pay two every turn to draw a card. I mean, you can just declare one of your creatures unblockable. It doesn't even have to attack. So I guess you do have to discard cards, though, at some point. But not bad. Not bad. Okay. Last pack of the booster box, and we shall see. Well, that was a really bad opening. Good job, Christopher. All right. Let's just rip the package in half. Okay. And we're going to go to Oval Chase Daredevil. Getting a lot of those. Ceremonious Rejection. I think that's the first one of those we've seen. Aether Hub. And our rare is the Aether Squall Ancient. Two blue, five colorless flying. You get three energy counters at the beginning of your upkeep. And pay eight energy counters. Return all other creatures to their owner's hands. Activate this ability only anytime you could cast a sorcery. I suppose that's not horrible. It'd be a good... it doesn't require tapping or anything, so you could do it on your first turn. So that'd be kind of neat if you had enough energy counters. So, my friends, we have had a very, very interesting first box of Kaladesh. I don't recall. I believe it was in this one, but let me see where it was. No, it wasn't in that one. I was incorrect. Maybe it was in pack number two, in row number two. But either way, we found several mythic rares. Not as many as I would have liked, but we did end up with this puppy, the Crucible of Worlds, and for that I am very, very grateful. And hopefully you guys have enjoyed this video. If you want to see more of these unboxings of Magic card boxes, let me know. I'll probably end up buying at least a box a month from now on. I've got the budget to do it now, and probably even more than that if we really get into this thing. But again, very, very cool. Just picking out this one card in and of itself. But I'm quite grateful for what I've seen in this set. Let's put it on the combustible gear hole because that's a really nice looking card. I like that guy. Oh, look at that. He slid over just so the other guy could have another peek through. Anyway, hope you guys have enjoyed it. If you have any comments or questions, please feel free to leave those in the comment section down below. Also, be sure to leave a thumbs up on this video and subscribe to AG Productions if you haven't done so already so you don't miss any of these cool videos. Thank you again for watching, everyone. I really, really appreciate it. God bless you all. Have a phenomenal rest of your day, and I will see you all in the next video.